Good morning. As I pull on this wooden block using this force sensor and this string, Billy, could you please give me the free body diagram of all the forces and their directions that are acting on the wooden block?
Sure.
Flippin' physics.
The force of gravity is down, the force normal is up, the force of tension is to the left, and the force of static friction is to the right. Static and not kinetic friction because the block is not sliding relative to the table.
Thank you. Now, in a moment we are going to draw a graph of the force of tension, and it will include the force of friction. In order to understand that graph, we need to first sum the forces in the x direction. Bobby, could you please do that?
The net force in the x direction equals the force of static friction, which is positive because it's to the right, minus the force of tension, minus because it's to the left. All that equals the mass of the block times the acceleration of the block in the x direction. However, the block isn't moving, so the acceleration in the x direction equals zero. Therefore, the force of static friction equals the force of tension.
Which means, as long as the block is not moving, the force of static friction and the force of tension have the same magnitude. Now, as I pull on the force sensor, we get a graph of the force of tension as a function of time. And because the block isn't moving, this is also a graph of the force of static friction as a function of time. And you can see that force of static friction increases and decreases to prevent the block from moving. Let's start over with a new graph, only this time I'm going to steadily increase the force of tension until the block starts to move.
Okay, I am slowly increasing the force of tension and therefore the force of static friction until the block starts to move and it switches from static to kinetic friction.
Let's watch that one more time and carefully note when the block starts to move. It starts to move right now. All right, let's take a closer look at that graph.
You can see the first part is all static friction when the block is stationary and the force of tension equals the force of static friction. This means the maximum force of static friction is also the maximum force of tension. Then the block starts to move and the friction switches to kinetic. After the block starts to move, the force of tension decreases because, well, actually, Bo, why do you think the force of tension decreases when the block starts to move?
Because the coefficient of static friction is greater than the coefficient of kinetic friction.
We are looking at a graph that shows that it is harder to put something in motion than it is to keep something moving. Very nice, Mr. P.
Thank you, Bo, and thank you for learning with me today. I enjoyed learning with you.